I'm pretty sure you know, watching math and science video is fun, but what's even better is hands-on learning. So let me introduce you guys to today's sponsor, Kiwico. They offer super cool hands-on projects and activity designed to expose kids to concepts of science, technology, engineering, art, and also math. When I first opened the box, I could see why a lot of people are getting this for their kids. It comes with a magazine, and then of course the menu, and of course, they include everything that you need to build the project. For this particular one, we are going to do an air cannon. And of course, right here, they show you how to build the project. And this is definitely a great way to keep your kids learning at home. More importantly, they have a total of 9 different subscriptions for all ages. So if you want a great way to keep your kids engaged while learning, then go ahead and get them one of the box right here. And if you use the link in the description, then you can get a 30% off discount for any Kiwico subscription. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I want to thank Kiwico for sponsoring this video.
Let's say if B is equal to 2, then we see that, okay, the curves, they don't touch. And now, a quick question for you guys is that, should we increase the B or should we reduce the B? The answer is we should reduce the B. So let's try 1.5. Okay, they still don't touch, but we can see that they are getting closer, so let's go ahead and try 1.4. Okay, they do touch, but this time they touch at 2 points. We don't want that. We just want 1 point. So now we can see that the B value must be in between of 1.4 and 1.5, so let's just keep that in mind. Now, how can we solve this though? Technically, this is just a typical Calc 1 question. Whenever we have two curves touching each other in a tangent way, then we will just have to do the following. The first thing is that we'll just make the functions equal to each other. So we are looking at b to the x being equal to log base b of x. Good. And then in order for us to have they touch each other like this in a tangent way, we also have to make sure that they have the same derivative. So let's look at this and differentiate that, and we will get b to the x and multiply by lnb. And if we differentiate this, we get 1 over x and then lnb. Cool. So we do have a system of equations, but how to solve this? Shall we? Okay, this is b to the x, so shall we just put this right there and do it? And try. If you put this right there, you can solve for x in terms of b, and I will tell you this right here will give us x being equal to e to the Lambert W function of 1 over lnb. I'm not kidding, all right? And then you can go ahead and put this back to here and here and then try to solve for b, or you can put this back to here and here and try to solve for b. But let me tell you, don't do this because it will be horrendous. So what do we do then? Here is the deal. Let's take a look at this picture again. Whenever we have an original touches its inverse, well, at this point that we can see, what's so special about this point? Well, let me give you guys a hint. How can we get the inverse from its original if we look at the picture? Well, the answer is we take a look at the original and we flip it about the line y is equal to x, namely this diagonal line. So as you can see right here, if they do intercept, they will have to intercept each other on this line. So instead of looking at b to the x is equal to log base b of x, in fact, we can just say, let's go ahead and make b to the x being equal to just x, or log base b of x just equal to x. But in order for this idea to work, let me just write down this note for you guys. We must have the function to be increasing so that whenever we look at the equation f of x being equal to its inverse, by the way, this is not a functional equation that we're solving. I know it looks like a functional equation, but here we're just trying to find out an x value or maybe more to make this equation work. All right, instead of solving this equation, we can actually just solve f of x being equal to x, or if you would like, you can look at the inverse version of it as well. And either this or that will make the whole equation so much easier. And just a quick shout out to Mu Prime F because I learned this from him. And if you guys want to see a detailed explanation, go ahead and check out his video. Let's use b to the x to be x. And then we do the same thing. We will have to make sure that they have the same derivative. So differentiate this, we get b to the x times ln b, and then differentiate that, we get 1. So much easier, isn't it? Even though this system of equations easier, but it's still kind of tricky though, so be really careful. What we can do first is that we notice b to the x is just equal to x. So we can of course put this x right here for that. So we are going to get x times ln b being equal to 1. That's nice. But now what? Well, I want to produce an ln b, and maybe let's use the first equation again. So have a look. Right here, let me write down b to the x is equal to x again. But I'm going to take the natural log on both sides. So that first we can put the x to the front, but you see we have the ln b. So here we have x ln b, this is done h. And that will just be equal to what? Ln x. And guess what? We know that x ln b is equal to ln x. So the whole thing here is actually just very nicely equal to ln x. Very nice, huh? So ladies and gentlemen, ln x is equal to 1. And of course, just exponentiate both sides, we get x being equal to 1. No, just kidding. E. X is equal to E. Yeah. All right, but we're not done yet because this is just x. We want to find out what b is. So of course, we can put down the E to this x and that x. So we are going to get, okay, let me just put this down. We have b to the e's power being equal to e. And ladies and gentlemen, to solve for b, we can just raise both sides to the 1 over e's power, like so, so that this and that will cancel. And we will just get b being equal to e to the 1 over e's power. Or if you would like, you can write this as the e's root of e, which is really, really cool. And as we talked about it earlier, this right here is indeed approximately 1.44466678 and then 6 and so on. So what do you guys think? Have a look.